An experienced diver today is much more likely to survive than a diver from years ago. There have been significant increases in the quality of diving training and the efficiency of equipment over the previous few decades, resulting in diving operations being safer than ever before, with South Australia's accident rate remaining very low. However, when a group of four experienced divers opted to explore a small, rarely visited water-filled cave in a vast pine forest of East Mount Gambier on their way back home, the cave became infamous overnight as three of them tragically lost their lives as one lived to tell the tale. The hole was located in the forest of Mount Gambier in South Australia, and the small sinkhole had very clear water that looked inviting to the party, which included 17-year-old Ron, 18-year-old Sandra, 17-year-old Christopher, and 39-year-old Dave. Mount Gambier is the second most populated city in South Australia. The city is renowned for its geographical features, particularly its volcanic and limestone features, which include lakes, parks, caverns, gardens, and sinkholes. The group had diving experience. Dave was a very experienced diver who had been on the scene for over 15 years. Although all experienced divers, none of them had any experience cave diving. It was Monday the 9th of October, 1972, and the group were travelling back from a diving weekend when they decided to take a quick look at the sinkhole, which was rumoured to be around 20 metres deep. The four divers entered the water with full tanks, but they left their normal safety guideline in the car. They did this as they didn't intend to travel far and didn't believe that there were any large underwater expansions heading off from the main entry chamber. After swimming around for about 5 minutes in the shallows, the group swam down the west side and examined the only moderately open spot that they could find. They discovered a low, flat passage between some rocks at a depth of around 6 meters. And Dave, as the team's leader, announced to the others that he was going to go in and check it out, with Ron following. The pair found themselves in a large cavern, which had clear waters, but when Ron returned his attention on the entrance to watch the others pass through, he noticed that the route was silted out as a result of them swimming through the passage. The entrance had become silted out as a result of them disturbing the soft, deep muck on the passage's floor as they passed through. Ron grew quite concerned about this and believed that they should waste no time in searching around the chamber, so the group began looking for the exit tunnel as soon as possible to avoid the silt completely blocking their view. However, the group were already too late. As they tried looking for the entrance of the passage, they ended up disturbing more silt from the cave floor in the process. Their visibility was now reduced to nothing. They couldn't even see their own torches. The pair knew that they were in trouble and spent the next 30 minutes looking for the entrance to the chamber. Due to the silt, they lost contact with each other and the others. With time running out, Ron frantically looked for the exit. Soon after, he came up upon a diver's motionless body, which was lying face down. He left the body and continued to feel around the walls, only to discover that he was having difficulty inhaling. Ron knew death was only minutes away. At one stage, he even lost his regulator, but fortunately managed to relocate it. Miraculously, Ron found the exit and managed to swim to safety when he observed a dim green circle of light overhead. After swiftly informing the surface party of what had occurred, he returned to the water's edge and attempted to home the others out by tapping on his cylinder so that they could hear it, but this failed and none of the others were able to escape in time. The bodies of the others were recovered the next day by Dave's friend, Mac. Mac was a very experienced diver, but this was a dangerous recovery mission in which Mac got stuck himself numerous times. While Dave's body was discovered only a short distance inside, Chris and Sandy were discovered together in a narrow, dead-end path at the far end of the main room, which they would have mistaken for the exit passage. The cave was therefore after restricted to sport diving and is now surrounded by a concrete block with a gate. The cave was nicknamed Death Cave after a newspaper reported about the incident the following week, and this incident remains infamous to this day. The group would have survived if they would have taken a guideline and avoided the line trap flat in a section near the entrance. Many believe the nickname of Death Cave is undeserving, as it implies the cave itself is a killer, when in reality it was the mistake of the divers that led to their demise. Thanks for watching.